Imagine Mojolo own you to a point where now you're just like, man, maybe I shouldn't be dating men. Maybe I should move to women. This type. Oh, medar. Literally, oh, haole molala de. Guys, bare Mojolo does not discriminate. Baratonati. Hello, beautiful people. My name is Jaro Mhlabe and welcome to my channel. If it's the first time here, just know that you are welcome to the track. Oh, ja bra, yeah, my sister. I want that bra. Usala we ya para fru. We are Meroko. Kuru uya mayema man. Uya mayema. Never come kwen. Ever come kwen. Meroko bossir. Uwa meroko wana banyaka. Take off that bra. Please. Just take off that bra and be comfortable. And if you are a returning subscriber and this is your vibe, purr, period, then you know that I appreciate you so much. Now, you guys, I'm just going to be getting straight into it, okay? Wait, hold on. Guys, we are now half monetized. So if you want to donate some money to this channel, there is a thanks button down below. Just below there, you will see subscribe button, like button. There is also a thanks button. If you click on that button, you will see there's like plenty of options where you can check which one you can afford and donate some money to this channel. You know why is it important to donate some money? Because Sanje Gidi, because Henka Saji, Ketorakota Mokawa, guys, Katlala, so please just make sure you donate something. I think it starts from 14 Rand. So, yeah, and also thank you so much, you guys, for subscribing, for watching. We are literally this close to getting fully monetized. Anyway, let me not waste much of your time. So, you guys, hey, yo, I'm sorry for laughing. Hey, Etle, guys. Like I said, when I call you hi, we jam lata ka fruit, but we wanna be solo out there. People babona marahuanora out there. Literally, you guys, I thought hore batu wapila peacefully until I'm on social media every day. Then I'm just like, hey, diabu waka monte. I'm sure you've been following the story yakadi no molesani, you guys, and yo, what a story. What a story and what an ending. I did not like the ending of it because I'm just like, girl, you just left us hanging. And I don't like the fact that, not the fact, hey, don't come for me, don't. I don't like that she did not finish it, and it seems like she was kind of like threatened at the end when she was revealing those phone calls, and it seems like she was literally threatened, you guys. That woman, well, I think she was just like, may Yvonne are. You try one more time, jail. You literally try one more time. You think you have money, but let's go tell that girl, bitches be quick, but I'm quicker. Me Yvonne Urile. Huh? You think you got money, girl? Yay. So you can never try me. So you guys, if you have not been following the story, Udino Molesan was in love with this woman called Yvonne. And honestly speaking, I loved them, you guys. Like, I really loved that they were always traveling. The content was crazy. I literally thought Dineo found the one, you guys, until it just went like goo goo goo. Like, literally, it went just like that. The relationship ended, and it apparently the relationship ended because of a friend, you know, Miss Tato. Yeah, apparently she was Dino Molesani's best friend, and when Dino went to is it UK? Turkey, yes, I think it's Turkey. When she went to Turkey to get her teeth done, Tato are hey emgel. How wanna hey? We share this hot partner. Why say we did a man on a ladder? Get up with Jayo. Then Miss Tato saw the opportunity. I shumisha hamana to drunk. I chat the woman, and she started dating the woman. Apparently, she traveled with her. The normal son was also there. I didn't know where she had a son. I don't understand that part. I would never say batonjile motho wa mang, you know, because I don't believe that honale a full grown human being, unless ili kidnapping, you guys, unless ili kidnapping, then I don't think hore gona le motho ka utswang motho out there, or unless if it's a child, then now we are talking, okay? So I just feel like Haisham, I do feel sorry for her. I do feel sorry for her, and I just hope she does not blame herself and be like, what is wrong with me? What is wrong? There is absolutely nothing wrong with you. If your partner cheats, he does whatever, or she does whatever, that does not have anything to do with you but them. It is not your problem. It is not your fight. Literally, just move on. One day, you will find a person that really appreciates you, you know. And I saw some people saying, yeah, Bamulayile, she was bragging a lot. Guys, you brag or you don't. You brag or you don't. You post or you don't. People that don't post their partner does not automatically mean their partner doesn't cheat. It basically means sometimes you just don't want the public embarrassment. Sometimes it's just that. Sometimes people are just private in general. Sometimes people just don't want to share their partners in general. And there are us who like to post. There are people out there who just want to show the world what it is. I am happy. And sometimes it's not even about people, it's just about them. People, some people get fulfilled just by capturing moments and posting. People who are literally blaming her, I don't understand why they do that. I don't, literally. Even if she did not brag about her, she was still gonna go. Someone was still gonna date her. She was probably dating during the relationship, so you literally never know, hey? Moving to the next topic, which is kind of like a sensitive one, you guys. I'll be talking about Olerato Kanyago, including Uino Morolong. Yeah. So Olerato did mention that, basically, when we were asking her, where is Olerato Kanyago? Like, where is she? Because people were ready to relocate Johannesburg, because apparently her husband was ready to buy her the whole of Johannesburg, you know. And when we were busy asking, where is she? Wondering, where is she? She was literally mourning the loss of her child. She was pregnant, you guys, and lost the baby. And apparently this is like the fifth pregnancy, so I do really feel sorry for her, you guys. This one is really a difficult one for me. And I did not want to do a video about this, but I'm doing this video because of Ino Morolong, you guys. How is it from putang kore? How is it Ino Morolong ke motho kae? O le fasting le re leng go lona, because I'm really, really confused. After Lerato announced the miscarriage, you guys, hebo Ino Morolong show. She went live and she was just like, yes, if you are a mean girl, if you are a mean girl, you are insulting other women, you are looking down on women, this is something that is gonna happen to you. You deserve to lose the pregnancy. God cannot give you everything. Hey guys, because I'm so confused. The same woman who's got the nerve to call out other women and say they are sick and say their parents committed suicide through drinking poison, the same one has got the nerve to say Lerato is a mean girl. She was mean to who? Like, literally, I'm still researching for it. Lerato Kanyago was mean to who? Because maybe I'm still young, maybe the time Lerato Kanyago was a mean girl, I was not on social media. I don't know, you guys, like, fill me in. Do comment down below, let me know what happened. Who did Lerato Kanyago look down on? Who did she insult? Like, literally, just I just want to understand that part, because I am so confused. And I just feel like, no man, that is so crazy. Like, how crazy is she? How crazy Morolong can get? Like, maybe man, you guys, you know, there is this thing, AI, you can literally just say, make me Morolong, and then type the words that you want, and that human being will say those words. That is what I'm believing right now, because I don't think someone who is so vile, someone like would literally go live and say another woman is a vile woman and be like a motivational speaker or something. I don't understand that part. And I think she is so insensitive, literally so insensitive. Someone just lost their pregnancy and you got the nerve to say they deserve it. You got the nerve to say, to put God in a box or a cup where you can say God cannot give you everything. Who said that? Did God say that? Did God say, I cannot give one person everything? People, guys, know there are people with Lamborghinis out there, mansions, happily married, they have kids. So don't say God cannot give you everything. What he knows is best for you, that is what he will literally give you. So don't put God in a box and be like, she will never have kids because God cannot give you everything. God gives children to people who doesn't have Lamborghinis. That is so crazy. I will see if I can include the video here, you guys. If I don't, I will leave a link of the other video that I made on my other channel so that you can watch it. I'm so bored, hey, like literally bored. But anyway, you guys, yeah, I will definitely see you on my next one. Bye.